Hi there. So today we've got Sarah here, who's going to be doing a mock test. She's kindly agreed to do that. So, just so you know, Sarah, the test is going to last about 40 minutes. It's going to include one reversing manoeuvre and possibly an emergency stop. Okay. It's also going to include one tell-me question and one show-me question. The show-me question we do when you're driving, and I get you to demonstrate one of the controls for me.
Okay.
And it's also going to include about 20 minutes of independent driving, which you might guess today is going to be following the sat-nav. I will say as well, when driving, if you can please follow the road ahead at all times, unless road signs or road markings direct you otherwise. If I want you to turn left or right, I'll let you know in plenty of time. But please do remember, at any point, if you're not sure of where you're going, including on the sat-nav, please do ask me and I can help you and remind you. But just ask me in plenty of time so I can help. If you ask me too late, I won't be able to advise you where to go. I'll leave that up to you to then do whatever's safe. So we'll start with a quick tell-me question. Can you tell me how you would check the brakes are working before starting a journey?
You press the brake. You press the brake and make sure that it's not loose, that there is resistance against it.
Okay, cool. So, unless you've got any questions, just make sure sound's on. Unless you've got any questions, we'll head off. We'll head out of the car park here and then turn right out of the car park.
Okay.
Now, initially, the sat-nav is going to then say to you to turn left, which goes into actually where the test centre itself is.
Yes.
But, of course, just ignore that. Just carry on following the road ahead, and then it'll route you as normal.
Okay.
So, please drive on when you're ready. It's going ahead at the roundabout, second exit. As Sarah looks to move lanes, she does slow down the blue BMW. However, only because it's a minor, as a blue BMW appears very fast and he appears after she has committed to changing lanes. As Sarah's view behind her was quite restricted due to the corner on the roundabout and also the cars behind, I myself would have personally stayed in the right lane and changed to the left lane later on.
Take the exit, A23, Brighton Road.
Here is the rear view footage. Some examiners may give this as a serious fault. What do you think? Let me know in the comments below.
right, 4th Avenue. Turn right.
Safe place to pull up on the left, just somewhere along this road, please. Okay, thank you. It's the routine stop, so you need to do it several times. Please drive on when you're ready. Stay in this lane, the middle one.
Okay.
The satnav's going to get confused and say to you to keep left, but that's not right.
Keep left, then turn left.
But basically, the keep left is much further along he's talking about.
Is he?
Maybe it's people going out for the day because it's
Saturday morning,
but it's not too early. I might be going out for like a slightly late start on the Saturday morning. Yeah, it's just see here, if you would have wanted to keep left, it would have got you into a left only lane, so that's why I advise you just to ignore that information. Another routine stop, just to show you can stop and start in different situations. So drive on when you're ready.
room up there.
Find a safe place to pull up on the left, please. Okay, thank you, and drive on when you're ready. Safe place to pull up on the left. Okay, I might as well just end the sat-nav bit there. So we've done it for sort of 20 minutes or so. I was going to be used to do a parallel park, but I spotted the spaces too late back there, because at first it didn't look possible because it looked a bit busy, didn't it, back there? But there was actually spaces to do it, but anyway, we'll leave that and we'll maybe do a different manoeuvre later on.
Okay.
So, our director is normal from now on, so please drive on when you're ready. road, turn left. This turn here, Sarah does great with her speed, but reducing her speed for the sharp corner, something that often catches people out. However, she changes to gear 2 too early, then holds the clutch down for a long period of time. She should do the braking as she did, but change to gear 2 a few car lengths before the corner. lights coming up soon. Could you please turn right? Soon after the roundabout. Driveways be great. Let's go to the next one just so it's just a bit closer to what we're going to do. I just think these two would be great. Okay. That'd be good there, yeah. So just so we're not too far back from what we're going to be doing. I can't see him moving off anytime soon. If he does, we won't do what we're going to do. We'll leave it. But as you might guess, I'm going to ask you to do a parallel park here. So I'd like you to drive forwards, pull up next to this red car, and then reverse park, turns up reasonably close and parallel to the curb, trying to finish within two car lengths from the parked car.
Okay.
Now, of course, you will notice you will be blocking the driveway, but that's fine. Please don't worry about blocking the driveway, but please do not go onto the driveway. Treat it as a solid curb.
Yes.
So any questions?
No.
Okay, so drive on when you're ready. two car lengths.
Sorry, just moving my mirrors back. Okay.
So drive on whenever you are ready. Thank you. Recording again, so hopefully there's not too much of a gap between when it stopped and started. I'm pretty sure it got the parallel parking.
I hope so. That was a good parallel park, I think. So you could. I was happy with it.
I think maybe from the camera, I think it maybe overheats possibly.
Oh, maybe.
It gets quite hot because it's on for quite a while and it's got a cutout mechanism.
Sorry, as long as it gets the important bits. Well, it's all important, but waiting at a stoplight.
Yeah, not too important that, is it? When we reach the roundabout, we're going to be turning right, third exit.
Partially handy.
Basically, to tell people on the camera, there's basically a man with a board thing with a stop go on it, and he stopped all the traffic from going around the roundabout. I mean, we could pull onto the roundabout easily, but now we're stuck on the roundabout because it's all backed up the traffic.
Oh, we're moving, we're good.
Thank you. started from. Just make your way round to the left, just this bit of the car park. So just drive forwards into one of these bays on the right, for example, is fine. Don't worry if you're a bit wonky, just we're not testing some of this, just head in, and if you're a bit wonky, that's fine. Yeah, that'll be fine there. Okay, yeah, so you switch the engine off, and feel free to take your belt off if you want, or open the window, up to you, and just give me a minute or two.
Okay.
That's the end of the test, and I'm pleased to tell you have passed.
Yay!